All right, now we will see how to write the program in PLCnext software and then download it to the hardware. So it's quite simple actually. If you see in the last video, we have added this PLC in our project. Now this is the PLC here. Okay, this is the version. So what you do is go to the right side and you will find programs in the local data type functions and program. This is the main program. So right click and you add program. So this is my new program. And now it will ask me different options. So first of all, I would like to rename this and I will write it as main. Okay. Now it's an option if you want to write in ST code worksheet or letter diagram or a function block or kind of NOLD code worksheet. It's totally up to you how you want to do that. So let's take a trial of using this function blocks. This is my favorite one. So now you have this window. Let's say we want to do some operation with two inputs and one output. So what I will do is, I will go to my IEC instruction block, and then you have function blocks, and then I will go to, let's say, bitwise boolean. Simple one, let's take the boolean one. I have this AND operation, and now it asks for two inputs and one outputs, okay? Now to give the input and outputs, we have to first define these inputs. So I'll go to my variables. Now in this variable, I can define my input and outputs. So let's work with the local variable first. I'm not using PLC input and outputs, just the local variables. So I will type here, let's say variable A. I will just write A, and this is Boolean, and that's local. And I will write B, that's also Boolean, and output, let's take X, also Boolean. And this is a local usage. We are not using external IOs, just the local internal memories. So I'll go back to my code. So I was at variable and now I'm in the code. So here I want to give A, so I will double click this one. It will ask me for the input. I will type A and that's the shortcut. So that's your input which you define in the variable. So just click A. So this A is coming here automatically. Then I will type B and select the B. That's my second input. Now I will double click this one, then press X and that's your output. So you have two inputs and one output. That's my simple logic with local variables. All right, now the PLC program is defined here. So this is in the main program. Now we have to put this program in the task, because in this PLC, you can see here, if you click this PLC next to, if you open this one, we have some tasks and events. So we have to define the task in this ESM1. And the task is our main program. Otherwise, this will not be executed. We have to define it in the PLC. So how we can do is, I will write the task, let's say it's main. I will write main task, you can give any name you want. And this is my cyclic task, which will keep executing every 100 milliseconds, all right? Now we have to mention the program type here, which will be executed in the cyclic task. So I will select this one and select main, and this is coming from here. Now this main program is entered in our cyclic task, which will be executed every 100 milliseconds. All right. Now I will go back to my main logic. And now everything looks okay. Now I'm just going to download this logic in the PLC with the task as well. So right click this EXE, this is your controller. Right click this one, this is a shortcut, and click write and start project. So this will recompile your programming. And then you will see the status on the bottom. Maybe you don't see here because of my photo. There is a status which will write to the controller. So this is now written to the controller. Now if I open my task from here, and this is how you can see the task is being executed. Right now A is false, B is false, so my output is false. These are the local variables. So the idea is I have to turn it on. So I can right click, and I can write override and force. So I will make it true. And this will override true here. Similarly here, I can right click, override and force. I'll make it true. And this will be true. And the result will be true because of the AND operation. Okay, this is just how you can test your logic by forcing the inputs. But this is we are doing just because we are using local variables. We can also use PLC input outputs. We have some PLC input outputs in our trainer. We can use that in the next video. I will show you how to use external IOs and execute the program. In this video, we have only seen how to make a logic and how to define the variables, local variables in the IOS, and then how to put this main program in the task, in the main task, and then how to execute it, how to download that. Okay, in the next video I will show you how to work with external IOS, which will be more interesting. So I'll see you in the next video.